Hello, everyone, and welcome to Cannabis Field in Corpus Christi as we film in the game of, for the quarterfinals for the state championship between the East West Georgetown and the Southwest Javelinas. Let me introduce to you the lineup for Georgetown East View. Number 0, Josecito Mestic, senior. Double 0, Brendan Soto, senior. Number 1, Jason Martin, sophomore. Number 2, Manuel Solarzano, sophomore. Number 3, Eric Boner, senior. Number 4, Edwin Valverde, senior. Number 5, Tommy Kegenhan, senior. Number 6, Isaac Lara. Number 7, Lars Matthews. Number 8, Oscar De Leon. Number 9, Ricky Aviles. Number 10, Luis Diaz. Number 11, Sean Monahan. Number 12, Calvin Vandergrift. Number 13, Blake Burton. Number 15, Daniel Orozco. Number 16, Joaquin Ugarte. Number 17, Brian Ugarte. Number 18, Eduardo Zuluanga. Number 19, Leon Jaramillo. Number 22, Dillian Latherkin. Number 23, Mario Vasquez. Number 26, Abdiad Juarez. Number 30, Mauricio Jamarillo. All these players, senior squad. Head coach, Frank Litterest. Assistant head coach, Jeremy McDowell. We are about to begin the quarterfinals between the East View, Georgetown, and Southwest Javelinas. I will now give you the roster for the Southwest Javelinas. Number 1, Jesus Acosta. Number 2, Hugo Peña. Number 3, Angel Morales. Number 4, Ivan Calderon. Number 5, Mario Perez. Number 6, Jose Benavides. Number 7, Miguel Vasquez. Number 8, Jose Arturo Sosa. Number 9, Michael Martin. Number 10, Humberto Medina. Number 11, Luis Escudero. Number 12, Manuel Ortiz. Number 13, Jose Eduardo Salinas. Number 14, Esteban Gonzalez. Number 15, David Reyes. Number 16, Francisco Montoya. Number 17, Armando Treviño. Number 18, Uriel Garcia. Number 19, Dan Figueroa. Number 20, Brandon Melendez. Number 21, Edgar Garcia. Number 22, Ismael Salas. Number 23, Jorge Cantu. Number 24, Diego Blanco. Number 25, Juan de la Garza. Number 30, Carlos Avila. Number 00, Jorge Treviño. Head coach, Jesus Palomir. Assistant coaches, Jesus Rocha, Rene Garcia, and Sebastian Romero. And here we go for the first half of this final quarterfinals between Georgetown and Southwest. Georgetown throwing on the far end. This field has become a very dangerous field. It's been raining all day yesterday and all day tonight. Javelinas controlling the ball in the midfield. There's Francisco Guerrero trying to get the ball. There's a little slip on it. Humberto giving it out to the right side to Uriel. Control by number 4, Ivan Calderon. Throw in for the Southwest Javelinas. On the near side, going to be performed by Uriel Garcia. Trying to look for Mark Martin, which was the key player yesterday at that 4-1 over Vandergrift. Mario looking for Humberto and looking for Juan Calderon. Shot at goal! There was a goalie right there, stopping that shot from Mr. Calderon in minute 38. Now this could be one of the most exciting games. This is the first time Southwest had advanced this far into the state playoffs, and they continue performing for this year, 2014-2015. Uriel Garcia with the ball in the center field. Gives it back to Humberto Garcia. Humberto is looking for a clearing, tries to find out on the side, left side of the field, trying to look for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez was the key player yesterday on that win over Vandergrift. He really controlled the whole game in the midfield and carried the team basically on his back by serving and assisting three times to Michael Martin. Oliver Garcia on the right side. Dribbling the ball through several defenders, giving it out to Calderon, who's now trying to center. That was a slide, very good slide by George West. George West controlling by number 19, Leon Jaramillo. Trying to kick it off. Again, Southwest regains possession of the ball, playing with Humberto, who's having the first 5 minutes at a very interesting pace. Now giving it to Michael Martin. Southwest cleared it out to the side. Offsides. Ball belonging to Southwest now. Uriel Garcia again with a throw in. Looking now for Francisco. A key for this game will be trying to control the midfield again for them. That was a clear tackle there. The ref didn't call it. It goes Uriel back again. Francisco Montoya giving it out again. As a center into the box, being cleared by George West. Now Southwest is beginning to put pressure on Georgetown as they try to come out from their defensive stance. It's a slip line. It's going to be a throw in for George West. Number 19 again. It has been raining, like I said, all night and all day today. The field is in a very bad condition. You can easily get hurt playing with these kind of conditions because most of these players are using speed. In order for them to control, they got to have that very good body control. If not, anything can happen in a wet field like this. Key things for the goalies. Try not to grab onto the ball. Try to punch it out as much as they can, because that ball is going to try to slip through their hands. It's all wet. George West now on the move. Clearing it out by number 6, Jose Benavides. It's a throw in being performed by number 10, Luis Diaz. Over here to the left side. Again, goes out. Another throw in. Jose Diaz again trying to find their forward, Kevin Vandergraft. That was a clear pass all the way to the box for Georgetown. Francisco recovers the ball right there. Now recovered by Mike Martin. Trying to look for Miguel Vasquez. There's a flag up. Offsides, Southwest. It's a little bit late of a call, but still it's a call. Now these two teams have come up with district championships on their own district. Georgetown undefeated, so as Southwest Javelinas. Georgetown trying to cover the ball. They're trying to see if they can, who can control the midfield, but again, somehow, Southwest is now having ball possession, and they've been doing a very good job. The forward, Jesus Diaz, trying to come back and recover that, defending that. It's a hand throw for Southwest. Uriel Garcia again with a hand throw. Humberto into the middle, trying to dribble through, and he loses the ball. George West recovers, and they're trying to look. You know, from up here, that looked like a foul from number 22, Dylan Locker. Somehow the referee's allowing them to use their hands. And they got to be very careful with situations like that. A throw in again for Georgetown. Number 10, Luis Diaz. Southwest begins this game with a 4-4-2 attack, so as George West. Marco Martin coming all the way down to defend and recovering the ball. Dribbling through seven defenders. Passing the ball over to Paco Montoya. Southwest loses the ball again. Being recovered by George West in the midfield. Pass it over to the side to number 17, Brian Alhuerta. Who's looking for number 17, Brian Alhuerta? They're brothers, believe it or not. We have two brothers playing in the George West team. Something very unusual. You don't see that a lot. Recovery again by Southwest. Great move by Humberto Garcia. It's a clear shot at goal. Recovered by the goalie for Southwest, Jose Jesus Acosta. I'm sorry. Avila, Carlos Avila. Georgetown is trying as hard as they can to put pressure on Southwest as they're coming out. There's a call from the ref. Head. It's a throw in for Southwest. That's a correction. Now they're giving it back to Southwest. Goal kick for Georgetown Eastview. Their goalie and senior Mauricio Jaramillo will be taking off the kickoff. Just by looking at the field, you can see that Georgetown is playing more defensively than yesterday against Porter. Just look at that ball. Humberto Medina was trying to look for Michael Martin on the right side. Georgetown is attacking only with one forward. They're trying to use their other forward, which is Mr. Jaramillo, as a midfielder and try to take control of that. As we all know, that midfield has become a very important part of the game, because that's where the game begins to control itself. Uriel Garcia with a throw in. And give and go again to Uriel, looking for Calderon to the side. Ahead. Throw in again. Uriel Garcia looking for Montoya in the midfield. Now, Luis Escudero got hurt yesterday on that game against Vandergrift, and he's right now taking a little break. We think that he might be used later on during the game as it calls for, but his injury is kind of a serious kind of injury. He got a twist knee yesterday. Again, this field really does that. I mean, it's so slippery that anything can happen. They got to be under control and be able to get that ball out of there. Georgetown kicking off again, recovered by Mario here in the middle. There's Humberto Medina with the ball right in the middle, taking it and dribbling it. Calderon with the ball. There's a kickoff. Defender took a little too much of a time there to try to keep it off. Montoya freeing that danger from the defensive side. The game begins to open up, as Georgetown is trying to take possession of the ball in the midfield. Recovered by Mario on the left side. Looking for Humberto Medina again. He's the one right now taking this team on his shoulders and trying to see if he can come up with a very good positive play in the offensive side. There's a kick way, 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 way out there by Francisco Montoya. The goalkeeper kept it out. Corner kick for Southwest. Wonderful save by the goalkeeper, Mauricio Jaramillo, the senior, stretching as much as he could to get that ball out. That was a shot from about 30 yards taken by Francisco Montoya. Corner kick for Southwest. We have a huge crowd turning into Cannabis Field from Southwest. We have about 200 people cheering up the Southwest Javelinas. Corner kick will be taken now by Miguel Vasquez. Playing it with Humberto Medina on the side, kicking it in. And the goalie recovers the ball and controls it. Trying to come out on this near side with the ball. Number 17, Brian Huerta. Francisco Montoya goes and recovers the ball. He's now looking for somebody in the corner in the box. Is being intercepted. Now is recovered by Mr. Huerta again on this near side. Francisco Montoya slides and recovers the ball over there with Miguel. Miguel Montoya passes the ball, and like I said, it's a very slippery field, and everybody's having a hard time trying to have a grip on the ground. That ball is recovered again on the left side. Catalina, Jorge Cantu, number 23, recovering that ball, giving Southwest that throw-in on the far side of the field. Looking for Jorge Cantu again. Georgetown intercepts the ball. Michael Martin looking for the ball, playing it on his own. And remember, this is the gentleman that scored four times yesterday against Gandergue. There's Calderon playing with Martin. Martin's trying to look somebody in the center, in the box. Humberto Medina's asking for the ball. He's trying to dribble between two players, and he sees that. The ball's being recovered now again by Humberto Medina in the midfield. He loses the ball. Recovers the ball again. There's a hand. The referee doesn't call it in. And he clears it out. Southwest clears the ball over here to the near side. It's a little tricky fit there. Center into the middle. Being headed by Georgetown. Slips off the head and goes out, throw in for Southwest on the far side of the field. Again, what a support these kids are having. Remember, this is a situation they find themselves in for the first time, playing for the quarterfinals. Miguel Vasquez is trying to recover the ball. He does. He plays it with Jorge Cantu on the far side. Jorge Cantu is looking in the middle for Michael Martin, who's all by himself. He controls the ball. He wants to take it on his own. He's dribbling through several defenders. He loses the ball against this fantastic defender, number 12, Calvin Vandergift. They lose the ball and looking for Martin again. Martin dribbles in the box. Martin shoots, and the goalie again gets the ball off. What a shot by Michael Martin at minute 25 of this first half, as the goalie becomes the hero again for Georgetown. Wonderful save by this goalie, senior Mauricio Jaramillo. This is the second time he does that. There's a corner kick on the right side for Southwest. And the crowd is getting excited and trying to motivate Southwest. It's been raining all night. It's been raining all day today, Saturday. So remember, this field is pretty slippery. Any shot you can take at goal, that ball can really go out and score them. There's the thing back to Montoya. Montoya's trying to try to center out. Hits one of the defenders. Michael Martin tries to recover it. He puts it on. He uses his body to cover the ball. He turns around, dribbles to several players. Referee doesn't call anything. There's a shot to clear it. Being recovered by the defense for Southwest. Mari on the other side, on the far side. Trying to look for Jorge Cantu, trying to look for Miguel. He dribbles to certain players. Montoya now recovers in the midfield. He's now looking for Uriel Garcia on this near side. Passes the ball over to Humberto Medina, and Uriel is taking care of the ball here on the right side, trying to look for Mr. Calderon or somebody on the box. He centers. Georgetown is there to recover the ball. Clear it out. Playing it with number 9, Rick Aviles. Aviles is looking for number 10, Luis Diaz. Uriel slips on the midfield. Now it's being recovered over here by number 10, Luis Diaz again. Playing with Uriel on the left side. He dribbles the ball. Gives it back to Diaz. Diaz is looking for somebody in the center. He censors the ball. He misses the shot. A clear shot at goal against Southwest, and he clears it. Humberto Medina recovers, and now he's looking for somebody. He retains the ball in the midfield. Nobody's open. He's looking for Martin in the middle. He loses the ball again. What a center for Mr. Diaz. Number 10 for Georgetown. Trying to look for number 13, Blake Burton, who misses that center. This game is becoming to be a goal and come back in a very offensive game. Francisco Montoya trying to recover in the middle. Humberto goes and slides. There's a bounce. Georgetown recovers. There's another center. Defense is there. And there you see that. It is very, very slippery, and that defender lost the ball there. Against Georgetown's recovery, and the ball goes out. Now it belongs to Southwest. What an exciting first half. Two shots taken by Southwest, and both shots being saved by Mauricio Jaramillo, the senior goalkeeper for Georgetown. Looking for Miguel Vasquez again on that left side. Miguel Vasquez had a wonderful game yesterday. He played fantastic for Southwest Javelinas. There's going to be a substitution for Georgetown and also for the Javelinas. Eduardo Ugada is coming in. And it continues raining here at Cannabis Field. Rain doesn't stop. Mario Pérez trying to get the ball. There's a shot at goal from Southwest. The ball goes out. Goalkeeper looks at it, lets it go. Now we have a goal kick, for Georgetown. What an exciting game we're watching. Two teams that are playing offensively. They're not keeping anything for the second half. They're trying to score as much as they can. And I think this is what happened yesterday with Georgetown and Porter. Georgetown scored on them first and play the rest of the game defensively. And that 1-0 was more than enough for them to advance to this quarterfinals. Throw in for Georgetown. Way on the far side. It brings it in. There's a little push and shove. Referee doesn't call anything. There's another one. Beautiful hand, beautiful feet play by Montoya and Humberto Medina. There goes the ball, slips to the defender. Calderon is going into the box. Calderon is looking for somebody in the middle. He censors it. Oh, he misses it. He missed it. Everybody overran that ball. Montoya with the ball. He censors it again. And the goalkeeper puts their hands on it. That's going to be a corner again. This goalkeeper has become a key player for Georgetown. He saved his goal three times already. Wonderful job by Mauricio Jaramillo keeping his team with a zero on the scoreboard. Corner kick being by Humberto Medina again. Southwest is getting ready. This set plays have become a very efficient lethal weapon for most of the teams that are playing in this tournament. These are set plays. There's the ball into the midfield. Miguel Vazquez comes and tries to get it. There's a clear kickoff. Montoya slips. Mario Perez once comes all the way over here and tries to recover it. There's one in the midfield. There's Uriel again. Wonderful play by Uriel Garcia recovering the ball. Montoya gives it in to Miguel Vazquez. Miguel Vazquez is trying to look for Martin. Martin is kind of slipping over on the side. Humberto Medina jumps over it, slips, and he misses the ball. Georgetown now is recovering the ball again on this near field. Number 12, Calvin Vandegrift gets the ball. There's a very good defensive play by Calderon. Ball still on play. And again, that's twice Georgetown has tried to center. That ball has made a tricky bounce, and they missed it. Here comes Humberto Medina trying to recover the ball. Vandergrift remembers and recovers the ball. He's trying to get a shot at goal. He does. Way on the side. Here comes the goalie out. He shoots at goal. The goalkeeper recovers it by Southwest. Wonderful save by the goalkeeper for Southwest, and he came out and recovered the goal. That's Carlos Avila. Wonderful play by the goalie for Southwest. The goalies are playing a key role in this particular quarterfinal game. Wonderful save. He came out, shortened the field in the box. Uriel is covering the ball over here on the side, and Uriel does that. Now this is becoming now a very physical game as Georgetown is trying to prove a point physically and pushing and shoving, and Southwest is maintaining their calm and patience, not trying to get too excited about it. There's a cross pass all the way to the far side to Mario Perez. Mario Perez recovers the ball right there on the far side. He's looking for Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya gives and goes. There you go. They're trying to look for Miguel again. Miguel Vazquez, ball goes out on the far side. Throw in for Georgetown. There's Mr. Orieta trying to recover the ball. Number four, Eddie Van Der Verde, recovers the ball. Gives it out to Eric Bonner. Looking for Mr. Urieta over here on the side. Number eight, Oscar De Leon is trying to look for the ball. And there's Southwest, and they missed it. And he recovers, and Georgetown scores. Goal! Goal, 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 de Oscar De Leon. At 17:35 on the first half. What a wonderful score by this gentleman. And like I said, you know, this is what happens on this slippery field. You are unable to control the ball, and this is what happens. You know, that ball just goes to there, and they done it twice before they scored, and this third time he paid off as Oscar De Leon scores the first goal for Georgetown. Uriel Garcia now recovering the ball, giving it to Mario Perez on the far side looking for Miguel Vasquez again. Controls the ball very good. Technically, he's a very skillful player. He takes a shot way offside on for the 40-yard line. That's a little too long. The ball goes out. Goal kick for Georgetown. Again, you know, I cannot make enough emphasis on how the field is playing a big part of this game. It is very slippery. The ball just went through several defenders to their feet until finally got to Oscar De Leon, and he took a shot at goal and scored on him. Humberto Medina trying to recover. Calderon is there for him. Again, De Leon recovers the ball, tries to give it back to Vanderhef, and Calderon recovers for Southwest. Calderon recovers against the ball, tries to look for Mike Martin. He goes through and dribbles to several players. He's now looking for Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya in the midfield gives it back to Humberto Medina, who then makes a very nice play on the defender. There's a hand. The referee doesn't call it. Here we go. The ref didn't call a clear hand. Uriel Garcia clears it out, looking over here for Humberto Medina. Franco Martin recovers the ball here on the near side. He's being marked by two defenders. Now there's three on him. He dribbles through them, and Diaz gets it and gives it back to Vanderhef over here on this near side. Francisco Montoya is trying to fight against De Leon. Francisco recovers the ball, and there it is. They're grabbing and touching each other, and the ref doesn't call anything on him. Here we go. Now it's becoming a more physical game now. Calderon, Francisco Montoya puts his cleats out there and recovers the ball. There's a pass all the way looking for Armando Jaramillo on the side. There's a defending covering the ball. He does, and it's a goal kick for Georgetown. What a wonderful play by Georgetown as they really worked on this play. They had done it previously two times in a row, and the third time it paid dividend. 1-0 the score. Georgetown 1, Southwest 0 in the 15th minute of the first quarter. And here comes into the game Luis Escudero, who was sitting down for about 20 minutes. And Jorge Cantu is going out after playing 20 good, strong minutes. Let's see how Luis performs now. Remember, he's coming out of an injury, but I'm pretty sure these guys are going to be looking for him, and he's going to try to perform as much as he can. There's a high kick, recovered by Calderon, hits it out. Recovered again by De Leon over here on the near side. Diaz kicks it off. And there's Uriel heading it out. Calderon tricks by the ball. He gives it out. There's an offside by number 8, Oscar De Leon. Very good defensive play by Southwest there. Everybody was playing online. Now here we go. Kicking off. Humberto Medina is trying to control the ball. Remember, there's still 40 more minutes on this game, and these kids, I'm pretty sure they're thinking about it like they were yesterday, and they're going to be doing something today. There's a kickoff by number 17, Brian Argurta. Looking again for this captain, for this team. Offside again. And I think this is what Southwest is not going to be doing. Offside number 22, Dylan Larenker. Going to be a kickoff. Trying to look for Mario Perez on the far side. Southwest moving the ball on that side. Mario is dribbling back inside, looking for Francisco Montoya. Montoya looking for Humberto Medina. Medina now is looking for Uriel, trying to move the ball around. Here we go, looking for Calderon on this near side. Michael Martin Sol clear in the middle. There's a center, and there's Georgetown slippery in two again. But this kind of centers, this kind of putting the ball in the box is going to be a good thing to do because it's a very slippery field. Number 19, Leon Jaramillo. Continuing dribbling the ball. He's one of the captains for Georgetown. He's trying to clear it out there to the right side. Miguel Vasquez is there on the defensive play. Miguel Vasquez recovers the ball. He's dribbling to the center. He sends it all the way in to looking for Mark Martin. And there's the defender kicking it way, way high. And the goalie's having a hard time trying to catch that ball. And that becomes a corner kick now on the far side for Southwest. You know, the crowd continues supporting Southwest. There's a lot of screaming, there's a lot of support, and these kids are really giving it 100%. And they're trying to come back from a one deficit into the 12th minute of the first half of this quarterfinal. Armando Treviño looking for that corner, gives it to Miguel Vasquez, gives it back to Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya hits it in, is being recovered by Georgetown, a goal kick. Wonderful, wonderful try there into centering the ball into the box. Uriel just missed it. Uriel Garcia missed it by a little bit. Ball went out, goal kick for Georgetown. They've been running since the first minute of this first quarter, and believe it or not, it's going to take a toll on you in the second half. Yesterday, that it was one of the key elements for Southwest defeating Gandergriff 4-1. They really pushed hard. They really ran all game. These kids are in great conditioning, and they've been performing again today. And they will continue performing for the second quarter. Throw in for Georgetown on the far side. Substitution for Georgetown. Brian Orueta coming back in into the game. Southwest is trying to recover the ball. Push and shove, and here we go. There's number 12, Kevin Vandergrift. Huge stopper for Georgetown. He's about 6'1", I would say. Very strong physically, and he's been stopping every try Michael Martin has had offensively. Throwing for Georgetown, far side. There's a little pull, ref doesn't call it. Uriel is marking there. Miguel Vasquez throws it in. Francisco Montoya hits it way over there, and now here comes Luis Escudero trying to perform. He takes a shot. Oh, up to the right. Very close. Very close. I thought the goalkeeper had touched that. And the referee says, no, he didn't. It's a goal kick for Georgetown. Going into the 10th minute of the first quarter. Southwest has been getting very close to scoring that tying goal. Unfortunately, the ball has gone out several times, and the goalie has become a very key, very, very important key for Georgetown to be in zero. Done three saves, fantastic saves in the beginning of the game. Throw in for the Javelinas on the far side by Miguel Vasquez controlling the ball, passing it over to Jaramillo. Jaramillo loses the ball. Uriel recovers in the midfield. He's looking for somebody to be open. He loses the ball again. Now he's going to try to recover. There's a through ball trying to find De Leon. De Leon passes forward a ball. And there was number 12, Manuel Ortiz. A throw in for the Southwest Javelinas on the far side again. Trying to look for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez trying to take control of the ball in the midfield. Being recovered by Georgetown again. Clear again by number 12, Manuel Ortiz. Goalie comes out, keeps control of the ball. He's trying to try to kick off to somebody in the front, looking for Michael Martin or Luis Escudero. Even Vandergrift, there it is. Vandergrift in the middle, doing a fantastic job. Once more again, Vandergrift in the middle is recovering every ball, intercepting every pass the Javelinas are trying to make. There's Humberto Medina coming down as defender, recovering the ball, gives it back to Uriel. Uriel misses the ball. Here comes De Leon. Tries to make a through pass. Mario Perez is there. Michael Martin is trying to find the Vandergrift again in the middle. Great position from this stopper for Georgetown, defending every ball in the air. Humberto Medina is getting the ball, trying to look on the far side for Francisco Montoya. That's too far, too hard. Throw in for Georgetown. Vandergrift has been a key factor in keeping Southwest from scoring. He's been intercepting every pass through the middle. The goalkeeper, key factor for this Georgetown team again. Ball being recovered by Mario Perez. Again, recovered again by Georgetown. There's a through pass being recovered by Humberto Medina, who's now a little bit down over here defending. And here comes Jaramillo trying to reach that ball. Jaramillo recovers the ball, trying to look for Miguel. Sends a pass all the way in. And Miguel is fighting for the ball. That ball continues on play. The referee calls now throw in for Georgetown. What an exciting game it's been. This is an exciting final. There it is. Offsides. They were trying to look for Mr. De Leon again, but there Manuel Ortiz played it fantastically. There's an offsides for Georgetown. Kicking off now again, the Javelinas looking for number 12, Manuel Ortiz, who's now looking for Uriel Garcia. Ball's being intercepted, and the ball slips out. It's a throw in for Georgetown again. It seems to be like the game is becoming to be a more of a low-paced game after that score from Georgetown. There's Medina trying to get the ball. Number 10, Diaz, is recovering again. There you go. Medina is looking for that ball. Something happened. The game's being stopped. There will be a substitution. Number 17, Armando Trevino, going out. Coming in. Number 1, Jesus Acosta, who yesterday played a fantastic game too. Substituted Uriel Garcia after that yellow card. And he's coming into the game now. Remember, this kid also has speed. He's a senior. And he's very good offensively. And he's, I guess Coach Palomino is going to try to do that. That's a push on Humberto Medina from number 18, Eduardo Zuluaga. Now, these are set plays for the Javelinas, and they worked on them every time and all year long. And something can come out of this play now. That ball is going to be looking for the center or in the box. There's looking. Humberto Medina dribbles the ball. He censors the ball, offside. Okay. Goal kick for Georgetown into the fourth minute. The score 1-0, Georgetown is up. There was a miscue back there defensively by Southwest, and they capitalized on it, and they're up 1-0. And I think this also the same scenario for Georgetown yesterday as they played Porter. The same play happened against Porter, and they capitalized on it. And after that, they defended for the rest of the 40 minutes, and they went home with a win 1-0. Francis. Number 1, Jesus Acosta recovering the ball. Looking for Uriel Garcia on this near side. Humberto Medina with the ball. Tries to find Francisco. He misses the pass. But again, the Javelinas are over here defensively getting ready and set. Pass goes out to Mario Perez. Mario Perez recovers the ball. Looks for Jesus Acosta. He couldn't. Humberto Medina comes down and defends. Now he's trying to clear the ball. He looks for Francisco in the midfield. Francisco Montoya is now in the midfield, trying to look for Michael Martin in the middle. Michael Martin with the ball. He makes a very good dribble into him, and he's getting ready to score on him. He's looking for it. He takes a shot, and the goalie again becomes a factor, stopping Michael Martin's shot from the 20-yard outside of the box. Wonderful shot. A great save by this senior goalkeeper that's keeping his team on a zero, Mauricio Jaramillo. Again, Southwest getting close to scoring. That's the fourth time they tried, and they're getting closer every time. For whatever reason it is, Georgetown is now getting a little bit tired. They've been running all game long, and it doesn't seem like they're gonna have enough fuel for the second half. There's number 6, dribbling the ball in the middle, looking for Humberto Medina again on this near side. Fark Martin is right there in the middle. He dribbles the ball. He dribbles again. He dribbles again into the defenders. One more. And it's stopped finally by Mike Griffin again. There's a clear shot from Georgetown. It belongs now to the Javelinas. Jose Medavines was doing a fantastic job right there in the middle, trying to look for Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina then tried to find Martin, but he couldn't. Here comes De Leon trying to take a shot at goal, and he misses. That was a clear shot at goal. The goalie came up, closed the distance between him and the goal, and that ball went out. Fantastic shot again by Georgetown. Unfortunately for Southwest, the ball went out. Now looking for Mario Perez on the far side. Mario Perez is looking for Miguel Vasquez, but instead he tries to find Jesus Acosta in the middle. They lose the ball. Francisco coming over here to the near side, trying to find. He recovers the ball. He passes out to Michael Martin. Michael Martin turns around, dribbles the ball, continues using his body in front of the defender. Defender pulls him. Here we go. There's a shot of Francisco. Francisco going to the line here. He centers the ball. The ball stays there. Griffin is there to recover the ball, and Georgetown clears it out on the near side. Hernan, throw for Southwest. Humberto Medina is going closer to the ball. Uriel Garcia is now trying to put the ball in the midfield. There's going to be a substitution coming up. Number 17, this young sophomore, Francisco Montoya. And then here comes number 8, Jesus Arturo Sosa. In for Francisco. They're going to give him a break for the second half. We are into the 1:09. Humberto Medina is trying to recover the ball. Uriel censors that ball. Goalie's there for it. He misses it. Okay. What a competitive game between Georgetown and Southwest Javelinas. The score is 1-0 into the first half. The field has been a big issue. It's contributed to a lot of miscues from both teams, as the ball has become a very slippery ball. And that's how Georgetown scored on this Javelinas team. There's a kick from 50 yards out. Ball goes out.
Okay.
25 seconds into the first quarter. Now, just by looking at and observing Georgetown, Georgetown is getting tired. These big defenders they have had made a fantastic effort through the first half, but it's taking a toll now as we are closing the first half. Humberto Medina recovers the ball, tries to look for Francisco. Francisco is there. And there's the end of the first quarter as Georgetown's defeating the Javelinas 1-0 on a miscue by one of our defenders. They capitalized on it. And again, this has been a very, very difficult game to control because of the way the ball is and the way the field is. Now, the goalie for Georgetown has become a fantastic key factor. Senior, let me get his name, Mauricio Jaramillo, has saved Georgetown from 4 scores against the Javelinas. Has become a very, very key factor, as well as number 12, Calvin Van Driffen, who has intercepted most of the passes from the Javelinas in the midfield. Now, we're going to come back for the second half, and I'm pretty sure Coach Palomin will be talking to his crew, and they're going to come out offensively like they did yesterday against Vandergrift, and scoring 4 goals. Three goals in the second half and going home with a win. Let's wait and see what happens for the second half. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. And we're back for the second half as Georgetown is defeating Southwest Javelinas 1-0. There's a throw in for the Javelinas on the near side by Mario Perez. Again, throw in by Mario Perez, looking for Miguel. There's Jorge Cantu taking a shot at goal. Recovered by Francisco Montoya again. He's trying to take a shot. Gives it back to Uriel. Uriel is trying to look somebody in the box, and he centers the ball into the box. There's Miguel taking a right shot on the side. Okay. Fantastic shot. Fantastic shot by Miguel Vasquez into the first minute of this second half. Now, Southwest is going to be trying to be offensively for this second half, but they also got to be very careful defensively. Georgetown will probably be playing counter-attacking, and the way the field is right now, very slippery. They got to be very careful in how they step into this. Mario Perez on the near side now, looking for Humberto Medina in the midfield. Miguel Vasquez is wide open, number 7. Miguel Perez again, now looking for George Cantu. He goes through and he gets to Miguel Vasquez on the left side. He tries to center the ball. There's Michael Martin going for it. Recover now by number 11, Sean Monahan. There's a shot again, a goal by Medina to the left. Now, they know they need to take shots at goal. That's another weapon they could be using for the second half. Humberto Medina is grabbing his right thigh, his left thigh, I'm sorry. Maybe he stepped wrong, a little cramp, but we can't lose a player like that for this second half. He's walking it off. It is very humid now. That also can take a toll on the players for the second half. There's a kickoff being recovered. Humberto Medina is now going to the center, looking for Francisco Montoya, who's looking for Calderon on the far side, being recovered by Georgetown. Giving it to Mike Griffin in the left side. There's no offsides. The referee says it's okay of a play. Georgetown recovers, looking for somebody in the middle, looking for De Leon. Flag goes up. Referee doesn't call anything. There's a shot at goal being recovered. A shot again at goal. They score on this two bounce ball, but now here comes the referee, the center referee, into the near side, talking to the sideman. As soon as he hits the ball, the other kid is in front, that's offsides. They're discussing the rule. And the referee says it's good, even though the player was offsides. The guy that headed the ball was not offsides, but the guy that scored the goal was way offsides. And the referee says no, for whatever reason it is. Here comes Humberto Medina trying to talk to the lineman. That is a very clear rule. The guy that's in front of one defender is always offsides. The sideman, the judge on the near side, called it good. Unbelievable way of calling. But again, that call is already made, and here it comes. Now the Javelinas are going to have to come back from a two-goal deficit. Calderon in the middle, looking for Francisco Montoya in the midfield. Dribbling the ball into the middle. Calderon takes off, looking for Martin in the middle. Covers the ball. Loses against the ball, and Georgetown recovers. Here comes number 70, number 10. Uriel gets on the defensive play. Calderon now on the far side with the ball, dribbling through some defenders. Georgetown uses the body very, very good in trying to recover the ball defensively. Uriel again with the ball, looking at this side, trying to look for Mario Perez. Mario Perez gets to the ball first. Humberto Medina is now looking for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez is dribbling the ball, dribbles to the inside and takes off number 11, Sean Monahan. Looking for Choche Vasquez again. He gets the ball. And the referee calls again a foul. A foul against the Javelinas. I believe the crowd is now turning against the center referee. But again, that call, that second goal, was not a very good one. If you see soccer, if you know soccer, there's got to be two defenders behind the ball in order for now to be offsides. And in this case, there was only one defender. That was an offsides call. Referee didn't call it in. Goalkeeper for Southwest recovering the ball. Looking for Medina in the middle. Medina controls the ball. Now looks for Francisco Montoya on the right side. Francisco looks now for Jorge Cantu. Jorge Cantu tries to hit the ball out. Francisco Montoya recovering the ball. Dribbles in between two defenders. Francisco thinks that's a wrong call. Here comes again the goalie for Southwest, recovering and playing it with Mario Perez here on the near side. Mario Perez is now looking for Miguel Vasquez. Kicks it off way out there, number 17 by Griffin. Miguel is trying to recover the ball here on the near side. Being recovered by number 4, Valvin Valverde. Number 5, one of the captains, Tommy Keller, recovering the ball, playing it now to the left side on the far field. With number 3, Elkin Bonner. Now this squad is all a senior squad for Georgetown. Most of these guys have had 2 or 3 years of experience in the playoffs. That's how many times they made it all the way here to Cannabis Field in the past 3 years. There's Montoya heading the ball to Uriel. There's the ball. Uriel keeps control. Uriel looks for Martin now. Martin is trying to dribble through some of the players. Jorge Cantu gets the ball. He tries to take a shot. The defenders come back. There's 6 defenders trying to get the ball. They kick it off into the middle with Humberto Medina is now setting himself down and recovering the ball, giving it over here to Vasquez on the left side. There's the ball being recovered by Uriel. Uriel takes it into the box. Uriel takes a shot. Uriel and the defender covers it. Here comes Humberto and here comes Mario Medina again with the ball. We have an injury player on the far side. I cannot see who it is. And the Carlies getting into the game now. That was a terrible call made by the ref for the second goal. But again, it's already made. The rule states it very firmly. There's got to be 2 defenders behind the ball. Obviously, when that defender hit the ball, there was 1 defender and a player from Georgetown. Here comes the trainer inside. What a terrible situation Southwest finds themselves in now in this final. But they're trying their hearts out. They're trying to score in the beginning of this second quarter. The clock stops at 33 minutes and 39 seconds. The score is Georgetown 2, Javelinas 0. There's a player getting up. I can barely see who it is. If I'm not mistaken, that might be Luis Escudero. That is Francisco Montoya, number 16, the midfielder for the Javelinas. Here we go. We're going to start again with a bounce ball belonging to Georgetown. There's still enough time in the clock for these guys to come back. They have a lot of talent, and they can really score on somebody very, very fast. It's just that motivation-wise, they're down now because of that score that everybody was claiming that it was offsides. There's a head in into the center field. Being recovered, he comes from this side. Number 9, Eric Aviles. Headed out. Ball belonging to Georgetown now. Number 11, Sean Monahan, will try to set the head, the throw in for Georgetown. Throws it way into the box. That was a bad throw in. Uriel heads it out. There's a collision in the box. It's a foul in favor of Southwest Javelinas. There's the kickoff. Uriel recovers in the midfield. Uriel Garcia looking for somebody, looking for Mike Martin. He loses the ball, recovered by Georgetown in the midfield. Here comes Hendricks. There's a slip by Humberto Medina. The referee calls timeout. And here we go. There's a yellow card. And number 10 is... Wow, what a turn this game has taken. After having a wonderful first half, we become now a very, very terrible second half for Southwest Javelinas. In substitution for him, here comes Armando Jaramillo, number 17. Terrible calls made by the refs right now in Georgetown's favor and against Southwest Javelinas. I'm sorry to say that, but that is what's happening right now, and you're able to see it now. Here comes a kickoff. Here comes the goalie out. He punches out the ball. Wonderful technique from the goalie. Miguel Vasquez is covering the ball. He comes out of there dribbling. Now the ref calls a foul, a very simple foul that if you look at it, it doesn't even seem to be a foul, but he's calling things like that way over here on the defensive side, and he's not calling it all the way over there in the offensive side. Here comes number six. Number six, Jorge Benavides, trying to kick the ball out, giving it back over there into the midfield to number 12, Manuel Ortiz. Manuel Ortiz is looking on the far side to Uriel Garcia. Uriel Garcia loses the ball. And there's a foul again, called by the ref. Obviously, something happened with the ref because he wasn't calling that in the first half, and now he is. I don't know if he understands what kind of mistake that was for the second goal, but again, he's making calls now that were not being called in the first half. Michael Martin trying to dribble the ball into the defenders. Three defenders around him. Looks for Calderon. Calderon is going to try now to look for somebody in the box. He senses the ball, and there it is. Missed by Jorge Cantu. Here's a little push against the defender for Southwest, Ortiz, and Ortiz is going in forward offensively. He goes in, he sends it back. That ball belongs now to Georgetown. Now, really, those Southwest took about three shots in the first half, and the goalie was the key player in that first half, stopping all three shots at goal. But again, it's just a game, and the game happens like that. Again, here comes Francisco Montoya in. And here comes, if I'm not mistaken, Luis Escudero. Coach Palomin believes that this kid can afford something in this second half, even though he's hurt. But remember, he's got a lot of speed and also very intelligent as far as playing with the ball on his feet. He's the leading scorer in our district with 26 goals. Here's Ortiz recovering the ball in the midfield. Miguel Calderon, Miguel Vasquez moving to the left side. Now looking for number 25, Juan de la Garza, who's now into the game. There's De Leon trying to save the ball, and he does, but he's recovered now by Mario Perez. Recovered now by Georgetown again. He's trying to look somebody in the box. Ball belonging to Southwest now, looking for Vasquez again. Here comes Ortiz trying in the near end by a throw-in. There's another substitution. There's a substitution coming in for Southwest. Score is 2-0 in favor of Georgetown. Coming out of the game will be Mario Perez. Jesus Acosta coming in for Jesus Perez. Number 25, Juan de la Garza going out too. And taking his place, Humberto Medina. Number 9, sitting down on the field, making it believe like somebody hit him. The referee wasn't looking at the play. Here comes Jesus Vasquez with the ball. This was the key player yesterday. Into the center field with Uriel Garcia's dad. Tries to look for Humberto Medina again. Humberto Medina gives it back to Uriel Garcia on the far side. Try to see if he can get Calderon there on the side. He does, and he finds out Medina again over here. Calderon is going forward. Ortiz in the midfield, trying to control the ball. He's looking out for Humberto Medina. Ortiz trying to control the ball in the middle. Giving it back over here to Francisco Montoya on the left side and near side. Luis Acosta now with the ball. Looking for Jesus Vasquez on this left side. He dribbles into the inside. He's going into the middle. Tries to pass that over to Francisco Montoya. Is being intercepted by Georgetown. Georgetown is trying to come out with the ball in control. Hits it out. Uriel Garcia recovers on that side. And again, referee calls the play. I'm confused on the way he's calling the play now. Because on the first half, little things like that happened. And he wasn't calling same. He wasn't calling any of those plays in the first half. And now he is for the second half. And what he does, he stops the play, and it becomes a positive asset for the team that's winning. There's the whistle. There's a kickoff in the middle. Humberto Medina recovers the ball. Dribbles the ball into the midfield. Trying to look for Michael Martin. Francisco Montoya moving onto the right side. Humberto still dribbling the ball. Francisco Montoya has it. Gives it back to Uriel Garcia in the left side. Giving it over here to Jesus Acosta, number one. dribbling here in the near field. He tries to dribble in between some players. Ortiz does the same thing. Uses his body to protect the ball. And here we go. He calls it again. And it stops the clock. It doesn't stop the clock every time this happens, but it takes seconds off the clock. He's going to try to look for somebody on the box. Looking for Michael Martin. There's Uriel recovering the ball. Kicks off on the side by number 5, Tommy Kennahan, kicking the ball for a corner kick. Humberto Medina, number 10 for Southwest, coming to the near side to recover that. He's going to try to look for somebody on the box. Everybody's moving around, and Georgetown is defending with 10 players in the box. One man forward for the counterattack. Here comes the center into the box. Headed out by Gundrift, number 17 again. Jesus Acosta recovers the ball, looks for Francisco Montoya. Has no one in there. Acosta recovers the ball again, tries to dribble in between. Ortiz looking for Francisco Montoya in the midfield. Montoya picks up his head, trying to look for somebody in the front. Jesus Vasquez doesn't get to the ball. Ortiz tries to dribble. Here's Luis Escudero, the leader scorer for our district. Looking again for Francisco. Francisco's going to try to take a shot. He does way high. Way high. That's a good try from Francisco Montoya. Tried to hit it from 35 yards out. 25 minutes into the second half. Southwest losing 2-0 against Georgetown. Kickoff. Here we go, bringing Sosa in. Here we go, kickoff for Georgetown on the far side of the soccer field. Into the middle. Defenders are trying to get the ball. There's Francisco Montoya trying to recover it. Ortiz recovers the ball in the midfield, trying to look for that. That's a slip on the back. Referee doesn't call anything on that shot. That ball continues going out there. That's a ball going outside, belonging to Southwest now. Calderon trying to bring it in. He's looking there for Ortiz. Ortiz misses the ball. And again, there you go. Uriel is trying to get the ball there. Jesus Acosta kicks it off. Ball now being recovered again by Francisco Montoya. Humberto is right in the middle by himself. Ryan trying to look for Escudero in the middle. Here comes Humberto Medina again. And the ref calls a foul right there in the 40-yard line. This is another ball that's going to go in as a set play for Southwest. Trying to see if they can get something out of this play. Everybody's going forward into the box. Francisco Montoya will be taking this kick. And trying to look for someone in the set play. 40 yards out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 men in the box. Being defended by 8 men from Georgetown. One forward left for the counterattack for Georgetown. Francisco getting ready to kick. Kicks it into the middle. And there's Uriel. They recover the ball. Trying to make a kick. Georgetown clears it to the far side. Throw in for the Javelinas on the far side. There you go, looking for Montoya again. Stopping the clock, the referee, somebody's injured. I cannot see the number from far away. Now the referee goes, unites himself with the first lineman, told them something, he's coming back. And we don't know what happened. An injured player has to go out, somebody else has to take his place. Way. 23 minutes into the second half. Here comes the substitution for Georgetown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 men attacking for Southwest on the far side of the field. Only 2 men staying behind defending. Here we go. Referee goes to the sideline, tells something to the coach for Georgetown, and now he's coming back again into the middle, getting ready to start play. Michael Francisco Montoya trying to look for somebody in the middle. Uriel Garcia, main man in the middle, together with Michael Martin, Miguel Vasquez, and Luis Escudero in the box. Referee goes and talks to the players. No hands on the players. Now it's becoming a very physical game. So anything can happen on a set play like this. Here he goes. Whistle comes on. Francisco Montoya centering the ball. Uriel comes forward. And the referee calls a foul again. A kickoff now for Georgetown. The senior goalie, who has been a very, very key player for this game, senior. Escudero with the ball. Looks for Francisco Montoya in the middle. Now sends it back to Uriel Garcia, who's now in return looking for Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya kicks the ball over here to the left side where Humberto Medina is at. Humberto Medina dribbles the ball, takes a shot at goal, off to the right. Okay. Now, time is becoming a factor now for this particular game against the Javelinas. There's only 22 minutes left. Anything can happen in 22 minutes. But it seems to me like they're getting down on themselves and they're getting kind of desperate. It's taking very lone shots when they've been looking for set plays. Mauricio Jaramillo, senior goalkeeper for Georgetown, has been a very key factor, key player in this game, stopping three shots at goal and keeping his net on zero. Benavides coming in for Georgetown. Kick off by the goalie for Georgetown into the middle. Humberto Medina is there to recover it. He hits it out. Vandergriff recovers the ball. This player has been playing fantastically all game long. Uriel gets the ball, gives it to Humberto. Humberto is now looking for Francisco Montoya coming into the near side, dribbling the ball still. Looking out for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez with the ball, tries to do some maneuvers. Francisco gets it. Francisco continues with the ball. Francisco plays it, and again, Georgetown hits the ball. Now there's pushing and shoving. The referee doesn't call anything. Here comes number one, Jesus Acosta. Offside. There's a little push and shoving. That should be a yellow card. Let's see what the referee does. Referee's just calling the Southwest player again. Number five, Tommy Kelleher, pushed the player with the ball but not being on play. There's no yellow card. That was just a warning. Here comes goal kick for Southwest on the near side. Again, the referee stops the play. Play cannot be resumed unless the referee whistles. That's the understanding what I get from here on top. Carlos Avila trying to kick off again from the near side. Looking now for someone in the middle. They don't, and here comes Jesus Acosta trying to reach for that ball. Ortiz is coming in, recovers the ball. Fantastic play by Ortiz. Looking out for Miguel Acosta. Miguel Vasquez misses the ball, and it's clear by Georgetown. Goalie comes out, Avila. Now he's looking over here on the side, on the far side for Calderon. Calderon is going on the right side. Calderon continues covering the ball. He sees now Sosa, I guess, on the other side, if I'm not mistaken. He tries to find him again, but he clears the ball way offside. Again, here he goes. They're becoming very impatient, and they need to settle down. There's enough time in the clock to come back from a deficit of 2-0. They need to be careful. They need to think more about what they're doing and settling down more in the field. They have enough manpower to come back and tie this game. They just need to concentrate a little bit more. Uriel Garcia recovering the ball. Humberto Medina in the middle, looking for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez covers the ball. Very good. Dribbles. There's pushing and shoving, and the referee doesn't call anything again. Fantastic play there by Miguel Vasquez. Here comes Jesus Acosta over here on the near side, throwing it in. Luis Escudero is coming to help out. He's now looking again for Michael Martin. There's pushing and shoving again. And the referee finally calls one in favor of Southwest on grabbing. Humberto Medina is laying the ball down. This is a set play again from the 35-yard, 40-yard line now. He's waiting for everybody to sit down over there in the middle. Here comes the center into the box. Uriel is looking for that ball. The ball stays there. Miguel Calvicet shoots a goal, and the goalie again stops. A fantastic save by their goalie and senior, Mauricio Jaramillo. Fantastic save. Here comes Luis Escudero, loses the ball, and recovered by Ortiz again. What a play by their senior goalkeeper again, keeping their goal in zero. Fantastic play. They had a shot. Miguel Vasquez had it and missed it. Here comes Ortiz trying to look for Jesus Acosta. Handball now. Here we go. This is too much of a waste of time. They could have got taken that kickoff away in the back. They don't have a offensive advantage over anybody playing the ball over there. Lost by Luis Escudero. Calderon comes into the play, recovers the ball. There's a little push and shove. Referee continues laying, allowing, and playing. Here comes number 10, number Diaz, looking on the far side. Ortiz goes out and covers. Good slide by number 12, Ortiz. Throw in for Georgetown. The clock continues ticking down into the 17 minute. Here comes a substitution for Georgetown. This is going to become an issue as the game continues. They'll be substituting and taking time off the clock. There's a throw in for Georgetown on the far side. Looking for number 10, Diaz. Diaz kicks it into the middle. The goalie comes out, Avila, recovers the ball. He's trying to look for somebody offensively. He uses his hands for a kickoff and looks for Michael Martin. Michael Martin dribbles the ball into the middle. There's a lot of pushing and grabbing in the middle. Referee doesn't call anything. Looking again for Humberto Medina in the middle. Dribbles the ball around. Gives it back again here into the near side to Jesus Acosta. Jesus Acosta looks down for Humberto and loses the play again. Hits one of the Georgetown defenders. There's the ball. That ball was way out, and now he's calling in favor of Georgetown. That's a real bad hit. Throw in, and the referee doesn't call it. Going sideways, uses his body to block him out, and the referee continues not calling plays like this. Here we go, and the crowd is getting into it, and now the crowd is after the ref, and you know, it shouldn't happen. They should keep from making comments against the referees or players in the field. Jesus Acosta covers the ball over there, goes out of bounds. It begins now, goal kick for Southwest. Avila looking in on the side for Uriel Garcia. Uriel Garcia on the far side, continues dribbling the ball. He's now coming back in the middle for Ortiz. Ortiz is grabbing the ball. Hits it over here to Humberto Medina, and that ball is intercepted again. Ortiz recovers himself the ball. Acosta kicks it off. And here comes again Ortiz trying to recover it. Acosta is coming in. That's a nice little kick on there. Sends it in. And Georgetown scores again on a miscue by Southwest on the defensive play. This is 3-0 into 15 minutes left in the second quarter. What a terrible, terrible place for Southwest Javelinas to be in now, being down 3-0. There was a miscue on the defensive side. They never kicked the ball out or cleared it, and Georgetown took advantage of that play. Here we go. Kicking off in the middle is going to be Michael Martin and Luis Escudero. The score is now 3-0. Humberto Medina with the ball. Looks over here on the far side for Jesus Acosta. Jesus Acosta is looking for somebody in the middle. There's number 6, Jesus Jose Benavides, looking for the ball. Calderon coming into the middle, dribbling the ball, tries to pass the ball, loses the ball, and it's being intercepted. Now, again, number six, Benavidez recovering the ball, loses the ball. Recovered by Georgetown in the middle. There's a foul against Southwest. There's a lot of miscue plays in this game. And here comes the crowd back again, trying to cheer both teams. Southwest going back defensively. One, two, three, four men. Georgetown attacking with four men in the middle. They miscue the play. Benavidez recovers the ball, turns around. There's a foul. Here comes Ortiz, trying to go on the right side with Calderon. Calderon continues dribbling the ball. Georgetown has become a very physical team this second quarter. Now here comes Ortiz in the middle, looking for Jesus Acosta on the near side. Jesus Acosta with the ball, tries to dribble. He looks at Miguel Vasquez again. Acosta gets the ball. Looks again for Michael Martin. He loses the ball. There's Acosta trying to recover the ball. It's a foul against Southwest by Jesus Vasquez. Now, Southwest has to be very, very patient if they want to use these last 13 minutes to come back and try to score at least one goal. They're getting impatient and motivated. Why? They're very unmotivated right now after that third goal. Humberto Medina trying to recover it. Comes in into the middle. Tries to dribble. Bicycle kick. It's not successful. Ball goes out. Ball for Javelinas. Ball on the near side. Another substitution for Georgetown. Here's Benavidez trying to dribble the ball in the middle. Looks for somebody open, gives it back to Jesus Acosta. Jesus Acosta is looking for somebody in the middle, and there's Michael Martin in the middle. Michael Martin turns around, looks for Uriel Garcia. He slips and gives back to Michael Martin. Michael Martin with the ball. Michael continues fighting, trying to recover that ball. Jesus Calderon is there to second man. Michael Martin recovers the ball, goes in between some defenders. He's looking for somebody to be wide open. He takes a shot at goal, wide to the right. You know, the Javelinas had a fantastic run this season. They went last year to 3 deep or 4 deep, and now they're in the final. They've been improving every year for the past 3 or 4 years. There's a substitution. Jorge Cantu coming in. I think now what's going to happen with 12 minutes left in the clock in the second quarter and the game, Palomin will probably start giving people some time, some playing time. All those sophomores that he's got, a lot of juniors that he's got on his squad that are going to be fantastic for this coming year, 2015-2016 season. This is a rejuvenating and very strong team, the Javelinas. Every year, there's a lot of talent coming in, and they're going to be back next year. I can guarantee you that much. Maybe stronger, maybe faster, but they'll be back into this tournament and be in the playoffs again the following year. Here comes Jesus Acosta to the near side, dribbling the ball. He's looking for somebody. Miguel Vasquez is there. He dribbles again. He dribbles again. He uses his body. There's a little pushing shot there. They call a foul. Here comes Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina gives it into the middle to Benavidez. Benavidez is looking up for somebody. He takes a shot at goal. There's a defender. The ball goes through, and the goalkeeper gets it, and they score! Goal! Goal, 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 goal! Uriel Garcia! Uriel Garcia, the senior, comes back and scores on a very, very bad play by Georgetown. The defender let it go through, it slipped through his legs. It got to the goalie. The goalie misplayed that ball. Uriel was there to recover it, recover the ball and score. The score now in the second half is Javelinas 1, Georgetown 3. With 11 minutes left, there's enough time for these kids to come back. What a wonderful score by Uriel Garcia, the senior for the Javelinas. Here comes Benavides giving it back to Calderon, and this game starts to get a little bit better as the time goes. There's a little foul against Ortiz, and he goes down after taking a hit. Timeout called by the referee. I believe he's going to tell him to go out. And he doesn't want to come out, but he's got to go out, number 12, Ortiz, because the referee called a timeout. That's the rule. He needs to go out and then come back in. It depends on the coach. Who's he bringing back in? Mario Perez, I think, is coming back in for a little bit, and then he goes back into the middle, trying to see if he can take his place again. There's a substitution for Georgetown. Ten minutes and 28 seconds. Here it comes again to the near side for Acosta. Acosta gives it back to Uriel in the middle. Mario Perez is playing on the right side in place of Ortiz. Here he is, Jesus Acosta moving forward, trying to look for somebody to be open. Gives it to Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina is looking for somebody. Michael Martin's right in the middle by himself. Benavides loses the ball. He dribbles in between. Number of defenders. He continues dribbling. He finds somebody there. He misses the ball. Here comes Uriel, the scorer of the first goal for the Javelinas, looking for somebody to be open. He dribbles and finds Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina looks on the left side for Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez recovers the ball. He is here on the near back, giving it to Humberto Medina. Here comes Miguel. Miguel is trying to dribble. Gives it back to Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina is right on the corner over here on the left side, looking for somebody in the middle. He sends the ball. Georgetown kicks off, recovered again by Michael Martin. He loses it. And again, here comes Benavides trying to look for Humberto Medina, who's now looking in the box for somebody. And there she is, wide open. He defender for Georgetown comes out and kicks it off. Bad play by Uriel Garcia, giving it back to the defender. There's a kickoff again. Here comes Jesus Acosta. And the goalie comes out, kicks it off, looking again over here for Jorge Cantu. Humberto Medina recovers the ball, makes a little flip. Cantu is there to see if he can get it. Loses the ball again. Here comes Jesus Acosta recovering the ball. Jesus Acosta is dribbling. He's now looking for somebody in the middle. Tries to look for Jorge Cantu. Jorge Cantu is going out there trying to fight for the ball. Here comes the goalkeeper out. What a mistake by the goalkeeper, even though he's being the key player for Georgetown. That was a simple play. He could have picked it up and decided to play around with it, and Uriel Garcia was there to capitalize on that scoring. Jesus Acosta going up there for the ball, recovering it. Here comes Miguel Vasquez. Uriel recovers the ball here, looking for Miguel on the side. Now turns into the middle, dribbling the ball all the way to the midfield. He now looks for Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya is going out there. That's the ball, man. Ball is loose again. And the goalie keeps it and kicks it out. What a play again by the goalkeeper. He tries to go out there and get the ball. He misses the ball. Now the referee stops the play again, and I wonder why. There's the substitution. Ortiz comes back in, looking for Calderon. Calderon is dribbling the ball in the middle, looking for Benavides. Benavides is now looking for Francisco Montoya. Calderon is going to try to center the ball. There's Michael Martin and Jorge Cantu. Georgetown kicks it off. Acosta is there to hit it back into the midfield. Benavides and Uriel looking for the ball. Here comes Franklin. He takes a shot at goal, wide to the right. Okay. Goal kick for Georgetown. 7 minutes left on the second quarter. This Javelina team is really giving it 110%. They have not given up, even though at a certain point, motivation-wise, they were down. And now they're coming back, rejuvenated to continue playing. Ortiz is handling the ball, gives it back over here to Jesus Acosta on the near side. Jesus Acosta is looking for somebody to be wide open in the front. He's turning around, looking for somebody on the far side, and Calderon is there for it. Uriel is going to try to play with him. Francisco Montoya on the right side. Dribbles the ball into the middle. Sliding to look for somebody to be open. He finds over here Humberto Medina on the near side. Miguel Vasquez is on the sideline. Now Miguel takes it in. Tries to center into the box. The ball's there. being defended, and Georgetown's recover the ball. Ortiz is coming in. Ortiz does a good defensive play, finding Jesus Acosta. Jesus Acosta is looking for somebody in the box, and there is Cantu and Uriel Garcia. Benavides controls the ball in the middle, gives it back to Francisco Montoya. Montoya takes a shot in the box. There's a bounce hitting the defender's hands. Referee doesn't call it in. Ortiz is on the far side recovering the ball, gives it into Francisco Montoya in the middle. Continues dribbling the ball all the way to the middle with Benavides, and now Francisco's looking for more Humberto Medina on the near side. Humberto Medina is dribbling all the way in, looking for Miguel. Bad pass by Humberto Medina. Here they come. Georgetown is trying to take some time off the clock. Throw in for Georgetown on the near side. Pushing and shoving again. There's the Leon, the only, I don't think that was a foul, and he's calling it. And here comes the ref stopping the clock. That was a clean play by Ortiz. And he's getting a yellow card. He was using his shoulder to try to recover the ball. And somehow the referee saw it differently. The sideman, the lineman on the near side. It's a foul waiting for them. Number 12 for Georgetown, Vandergriff, who's been a key player in this game. Here goes the ball into the box. Here comes the goal. He sleeps on the floor, but recovers it and loses it. And there they go, and they score again. Goal by Georgetown on a miscue play by our goalie for Southwest. Again, it's a slippery field, it's a slippery ball, and that's what happens. You misplay it, and they capitalize on this third time. Score now 4-1 in favor of Georgetown. Unfortunately, it came to happen with 5 minutes left on the clock. Motivational. Here we go. Again into play. Humberto Medina with the ball. Calderon on the far side trying to look for Francisco Montoya. Francisco Montoya gets the ball. Really is now an offensive player. Here comes the center. Miscues it. There it is. Miguel Vasquez misplaced the ball. Here comes Georgetown defending it. Here comes Georgetown playing on the near side with De Leon dribbling the ball. Here comes Humberto Medina. Humberto Medina recovers the ball. Now they look for Jorge Cantu. Jorge Cantu is dribbling on the near side, looking for somebody in the middle. He centers the ball. Recovered there by Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez is looking for somebody, and the ball goes out. It's a corner kick for the Southwest Javelinas on the near side. Bringing every power they have into the box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 players now in the box for the Javelinas. Corner kick being taken by Humberto Medina here on the near side. Ball goes in. He looking for Uriel again. Hits it out. Corner kick again for the Javelinas. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 players defending. 10 players defending for Georgetown. Here comes this side. Benavides trying to take the corner kick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 players for the Javelinas in the box. Here comes the center looking for Uriel again. That ball is being cleared in the defensive side. Here comes Acosta. Acosta is trying to dribble the ball in between the players. Loses the ball. Here comes Georgetown trying to get a clear shot at goal. Offside called by the dear lineman. Here it comes again. 1 unfortunate play by our Southwest Javelinas goalkeeper. He had control, miscued, and Georgetown capitalized on it. Out of bounds on the far side. Calderon bringing it in with a throw in. 3 minutes left on the clock. Uriel is putting pressure on top of there defensively. Georgetown kicks it out. Calderon throw in for Javelinas. Uriel Garcia coming in. There it is. Georgetown defending the ball. There's two attackers against two defenders. He gives up the ball Georgetown. They're now handling and dribbling the ball very good. Here comes Acosta trying to get the ball recovered. Two Javelinas slides on the floor, recover the ball by Ortiz. Ortiz is on the far side looking for Calderon. Calderon now looks up somebody in the man up. Here it comes. This is a slippery ball played. Here comes Jorge Cantu trying to dribble the ball, looking for Jorge Vasquez. Jorge Vasquez is reaching out to Benavides, and there's a player down. Jesus Acosta is now trying to follow the ball, fighting between two players. Jesus Acosta kicks it out of bounds on the near side, throw in for Georgetown. With 2:51 left in the second quarter, the score is 4-1 in favor of Georgetown. What a wonderful run this Javelina team had. A fantastic season. Gotten the farthest they have ever in the school history to the quarterfinals for state. There's a shot at goal by Georgetown, and the goalkeeper is there to save it. That's a corner kick for Georgetown. There's a player down for the Javelinas. Comes out, that's Ortiz. Number 12, Manuel Ortiz, who's had a fantastic game today, recovering many, many balls in the defensive side. There's a corner kick being for now by Georgetown. They dribble the ball in between. Now they're looking for somebody in the middle. There's a wide man open. Calderon is there to defend it. Ball goes out. There's 2 minutes left in the clock. Uriel continues running and fighting, and he makes a fantastic save. Calderon is looking for the ball, looking now for Francisco Montoya. He's intercepted by Georgetown. They recover the ball right there on the far side. Georgetown is now trying to dribble the ball all over the place and try to take some time off. That was hands, and finally the ref calls it. Benavides is there to get the ball. Makes a mistake again. Here comes Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez is running and dribbling in the middle. He goes around and tries to find Jorge Cantu. Jorge Cantu gives it back. Now he's looking in the middle for Humberto Medina, who had a fantastic play. There's the ball going in for Francisco. He tries to reach for it. He couldn't. The goalkeeper misplaced it, and he recovers the ball, and he's getting kick off from the box. 1 minute and 12 seconds left in this game. Congratulations go out to the whole Javelina soccer team, coaches, trainers, everybody that was an asset, a positive asset for this season. Oh, the ball goes in. There's Francisco kicking it in. Goal! By the sophomore, Francisco Montoya, scoring with 51 seconds left in the clock. What a play by the sophomore. Scoring from the right side, goalie coming out. He just flipped it over and scored. The game now is 4-2 with 51 minutes left in this game. What a fantastic play by this young player, a sophomore. Here comes the Javelinas. Everybody's trying to put pressure on the defenders. And Ortiz is right there, just quarterback in the team. There's the ball. Michael Martin recovering the ball in the midfield. Trying to look for somebody. Uriel is in the front now. Uriel kicks it out to the side to Miguel Vasquez. Miguel Vasquez is trying to dribble the ball. He's being pushed and shoved. Referee doesn't call anything. That's another corner kick. And they got to hurry up and put somebody on the box over there. There's Benavides trying to go and take care of this corner kick. Here we go. Everybody's in the box trying to score. There's the center in the middle. Michael Martin recovers. Calderon is right there trying to put the ball into the middle. He takes it in, takes a little thing bounce, and that's it, ladies and gentlemen. This game's over. Georgetown winning the final quarterfinal game for state. The game ends 4-2. Fantastic effort by the Javelinas. Great support from the crowd. Thanks goes out to everybody that supported the Javelinas this year. Great thanks to the administration and our board for showing support for this team, for the Southwest Javelinas in their 2014-2015. Again, thank you, everybody. This is Carlos Salinas saying goodbye and see you next year for our soccer season.